Psalm 30, from verse 1 to 12. This morning I didn't assign any of our believers for that reading. But if you have got a copy of the Bible, kindly turn with me to Psalm 30. From verse 1 through 12 I read. Psalm 30, verse 1. A song and song at the dedication of the house of David. I will extol thee, O Lord, for thou hast lifted me up and hast not made my foes to rejoice over me. O Lord my God, I cried unto thee, and thou hast healed me. O Lord, thou hast brought up my soul from the grave. Thou hast kept me alive, that I should not go down to the pit. Sing unto the Lord, O ye saints of his, and give thanks at the remembrance of his holiness. For his anger endureth but a moment, in his favor is life. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy cometh in the morning. Lord, by thy favor thou hast made my mountain to stand strong. Thou didst hide thy face, and I was troubled. I cried to thee, O Lord, and unto thee, unto the Lord I made supplication. What profit is this there in my blood when I go down to the pit? Shall the dust praise thee? Shall it declare thy truth? Hear, O Lord, and have mercy upon me. Lord, be thou my helper. Thou hast turned for me my mourning into dancing. Thou hast put off my sackcloth and girded me with gladness, to the end that my glory may sing praise to thee and not be silent. O Lord my God, I will give thanks unto thee forever. The caption for this morning meditation is, Joy Dawns. Joy Dawns. An alternative caption, Joy Comes with the Morning. Joy Comes with the Morning. In verse 5. For his anger endureth but a moment. In his favor is life. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy cometh in the morning. But joy cometh, the literal meaning is with the morning. As the morning dawns, joy also comes with that morning. The title of this song is given, a psalm and song at the dedication of the house of David. A psalm and song at the dedication of the house of David. It's not just the dedication of the house of David. Literally it is in Hebrew, a song. It's a song. A song of dedication for the house. A song of dedication for the house. For any house, a song of dedication for the house by David. A song by David and of the dedication of a house. Generally, the background of this song is not very clear. There are different conjuring. Some conjure that when David built a house with cedar and all, when David built a house for him at that dedication, or for the purpose of that dedication, this psalm could have been composed. That's one conjuring. And some people said when the temple was dedicated, but that was after David, only in the days of Solomon the temple was dedicated. Some people conjure when the temple was built by Zerubbabel, and when they dedicated the temple, this song was sung. That was much later, so it can't be a song of David. Some people say when they returned from Babylon, that also can, then it cannot be a psalm of David. It is said a psalm and a song by David. A song is sung with music. So it's a psalm and a song by David, and a description is given at the dedication of the house. But when I was reading this passage very clearly, I was reading this psalm again and again, and there's a very thin group of people has got a thought, and I subscribe to that. When David came back from his exile after the conspiracy of Absalom, when David came back from his exile, when he was coming back, his house, his palace was rededicated. It was defiled by Absalom. Many evil things took place. So probably this David would have returned this when he was coming back from his exile after the conspiracy of Absalom. When the internal evidences, the contextual evidences of this psalm makes it very clear that it would have been, the occasion would have been when he was coming back, from his exile after the conspiracy of his own son Absalom. My dear brother, my dear sister, whatever it could be, it is a psalm that God has given. I start with verse 6. If you got to, please turn with me to verse 6. And in my prosperity, I said, I shall never be moved. At one point of time in his life, David said, I shall never be moved. Okay, everything is settled. Nothing can shake me. I shall never be moved. When he was prosperous, when he was successful, in my prosperity I said, in my success I said, certainly when a shepherd boy he could not have said that. Certainly when he was in the wilderness he could not have said that. Maybe when he was the son-in-law of his the king, I don't know. And very much after he became the king, after he became the king of Israel, David must have said at one point of time, now I cannot be moved. I suffered a lot because of David, wars, this, that. Now I have become a king of a vast domain. I shall not be moved. He was a simple shepherd boy, became the son-in-law of the king, and misfortune fell on his way. Suffered for 7 years in the wilderness. When he was about 42 years old, he became the king. After suffering for 7 years, when he was 42 years old, he became the king. Now he says, in his prosperity, I shall never be moved. So maybe for nearly 17, 18 years he was the king. Victory over victory. Amassing wealth. He's giving a part of the wealth for the building of the temple. His kingdom was spreading. I shall never be moved. Nothing can shake me. Sin came in his life. Adultery. Pride. A prophet. A servant of God, a man who loved God with all his might, sin came in his life. The latter part of verse 7 he says, thou didst hide thy face. In David's life a time came when God hid his face. When he was in the wilderness, by the cave of Adullam, He said, I lift my face unto the Lord, my countenance is lighted. நான் கர்த்தரை நோக்கி பார்க்கிறேன். மை ஃபேஸ் வில் நாட் பி அஷேம்ட். என் முகம் வெட்கப்பட்டு போவதில்லை. எ மேன் ஹி வாஸ் ரோரிங் லைக் தட். ஐ வாஸ் க்ரைங் அண்ட் சேயிங், காட் டிட் ஹைட் ஹிஸ் ஃபேஸ். வென் காட் ஹைட்ஸ் ஹிஸ் ஃபேஸ், ஆல் மிஸ்ஃபார்ச்சுன் வில் கம் இன் அவர் லைஃப். இன் வேர்ஸ் செவன் ஹி சேஸ், தௌ டிட்ஸ் ஹைட் தை ஃபேஸ் அண்ட் ஐ வாஸ் ட்ரபிள்ட். When God hides His face, brothers and sisters, we will be troubled. The trouble in the latter days, what David faced was horrible. His daughter Tamar was raped and cheated by Ammon, his own son. He only encouraged Tamar to go to Ammon's place to help Ammon, but he never expected this evil would take place. He could not say anything. He was very wroth, but he could not do anything. It is his own son. His own son spoiled his own daughter. He is unable to say anything. Just imagine your eldest son spoils your daughter, who is very beautiful, whom you love very much, and you are in a position that you could not do anything about it. How much he might have been troubled. When God hides his face, this would happen in the house. That could happen in any family. Dirty, evil things could happen when God could hide his face. And Ammon was killed by Absalom, another son, the immediate brother of Tamar. Kills Ammon. Thambi annana kola seira. Daddy could do nothing about it. His loving heart, heart of a prophet, heart of a psalmist, it is troubled. He was a man of God, a man who loved God with all his might. He said, thus my house be blessed. This is how his house is blessed. One brother rapes another daughter. One son rapes another daughter. Another son kills another son. And when Ammon was killed, Absalom runs away to his mother's place, to that kingdom. In other words, David's Samadhi's place, father-in-law's place. Now David could not do anything. David could not wage a war against that king. Absalom has run into his tata's place. He was in that tata's place. Years were passing by. Absalom wants to come back. People talk to David, allows Absalom to come back, but he doesn't want to see Absalom. A few years are passing by, maybe another 4 years. By the time Absalom made an evil attempt, hoodwinking people, talking to people standing at the gate, see, my father is very old, my father can't do anything, I will help you, whatever the problem you bring to me, I will solve the problem. அவங்க கண்ணத்தை தடவி, தாடிய உருவி, கட்டி பிடிச்சி, அணைச்சி, ஒரு வேஷம் போட்டு, he turns the hearts of the people to his side. He knew what was happening. Now the hearts of the people are turned towards Absalom. It's an internal politics. It was happening there. David could do nothing. His heart was aching. When God hides his face, you will be troubled. When God hides his face, you will be troubled. One night, all of a sudden, Absalom declared a coup. To save the life, David and some of his wives. He had the sin of polygamy also. David and some of his wives. At that time David was approximately 60 years old. 60 years old. He was a king for more than 17 years. Royal life. Suddenly barefoot, without even footwear, barefoot, with bare minimum clothes, David and some of his associates, they were running into the forest. They were running into the forest. When God hid his face, David was troubled. He ran into the forest. My dear brother, my dear sister, maybe for another 4 years, 4 years, he was in exile. Went through a lot of shame. Shimei was mocking at him. One of his great counselors and ministers, Ahithophel, his very confident minister, he turned against King David and joined Absalom. You know why? Ahithophel's granddaughter was Bathsheba, Uriah's wife. His own granddaughter. So probably that was the hurt for Ahithophel. Sin after sin after sin. His own confident minister, counselor. The counsel of Ahithophel will be considered as the counsel of God. That Ahithophel joined Absalom. Absalom and Ahithophel. My dear brother, my dear sister, David was shattered. But after 4 years, David, in that 4 years, David went through a lot of problems. In Psalm 30, David talks about foes. Earlier in the wilderness, only Saul was the foe. But now, Absalom, Ahithophel, Shimei, so many other people. David talks about foes. And he was sick mentally, spiritually. He cannot go to the temple, tabernacle. He cannot worship God. He loved to be at the court of the tabernacle. Now he was moved away from the tabernacle he was building. In every way he was broken. He was sick. And he says in verse 3, going down to the pit. In verse 5, he talks about God's anger. In verse 7, he says, God hid his face. In verses 2 and 8, he says, I cried unto the Lord. In all those 4 years, when he was broken, he cried unto the Lord. Brother, sister, just stop here. Apply it in your life. The Lord blessed you. The Lord blessed you in the ministry. The Lord blessed you in your finance. The Lord blessed you in your business. The Lord blessed you in your family life. The Lord blessed you in your studies. The Lord blessed you in your career. You were to, from your cycle, you are able to buy a bike. From your bike, you are able to buy a car. The Lord has been blessing you in different ways. Now suddenly, because maybe our pride, maybe because we thought that we shall not be moved, sin after sin, doing things which cannot please God, happened in our lives. Now problem after problem after problem. We are declining. Why has it happened? The other day when we had the business person fellowship, one of the brothers was giving a testimony. He was in a very difficult situation. He was about to commit suicide. He attempted suicide. The Lord wonderfully delivered him. The Lord brought him up from all his debts. Wonderful healing, miracles took place in his life. He was going up and up and up. All his debts were clear. All his debts were cleared. Then today, he is plunging into debts. So many lakhs. What happened in between? True, you are suffering. The Lord, you received Jesus Christ. The Lord blessed you. The Lord lifted you up. Now what happened? In this exile, he cried unto the Lord. I encourage you, cry unto the Lord. Only the Lord can do a miracle now. Only the Lord can perform a miracle for you. He cried unto the Lord. Verses 8, 9 and 10. Please stand with me. Verses 8, 9 and 10. I cried to thee, O Lord, and unto the Lord I made supplication. Nobody can help me. Everybody is with Absalom. Even Ahithophel is with Absalom. I could feel in my spirit it's a prophetic utterance to somebody. To whom I can go and share my heart. I cried unto thee. Unto the Lord I made supplication. He tells the Lord, Lord, what profit is there in my blood? In my blood, what is the profit for you, Lord? Because I suffer like this, what is the profit for thee? When I go down to the pit, how does it profit God? With your failures, with your sufferings, with your pains, can that profit God? No, it's not going to profit God. What profit is there? What profit is there in my blood? When I go down to the pit, shall the dust praise thee? I'm reduced to a dust. Shall the dust praise thee? Shall it declare thy truth? Will this dust, when I am reduced like this, will that declare thy truth? In verse 10 he cried, Hear, O Lord, and have mercy upon me. Hear, O Lord, and have mercy upon me. Once he was arrogant. He committed sin. He thought that he could not be moved ever. Today he cried and said, Lord, have mercy upon me. Lord, be thou my helper. You alone can help me. It's a prophecy to somebody here. God alone can help me. God alone can help you. Nobody can help you. Your friends cannot help you. Your relatives cannot help you. Your own children cannot help you. They are against you. Your son is against you. Nobody can help you. God, you are my helper. When David cried like that, in verse 11 he says, Thou hast turned for me my mourning into dancing. Thou hast turned my mourning into dancing. Thou hast put off my sackcloth and girded me with gladness. In verse 5, For his anger endureth but a moment. His anger endureth but for a moment. Because I was arrogant. Because I thought that I cannot be moved away. I never be moved away. Because I wanted to have a licentious life. No, the Lord, you allowed it. But your anger is for a moment. In his favor is life. The true life is only in his favor. Only in his grace. Lord, if you can show your favor to me, I will have life. Otherwise, it is miserable. It is hell. Your wife is suffering, your daughters are suffering, your sons are suffering, your children are suffering. The pain around you, you are sick. Lord, if you can show favor to me, I will have life. Otherwise, I cannot have life. In his favor is life. Only in his favor is life. Otherwise, it is miserable, brother. It is a miserable sister. His anger endureth but a moment. In his favor is life. Weeping may endure for a night. This 4 long years suffering, he says, one night. This 4 long years suffering is one night. What is a night philosophically? Jesus said, a time that no man can work. A time that no man can work. It is directly the Lord is telling, what is night for you? A time that you can do nothing is the night for you. You can do nothing. Your education cannot help you. Your talents may not help you, your skill may not help you, your friends may not help you, your relatives may not help you. You can't do anything. You can't do anything. You can't move to the left, you can't move to the right. You cannot do anything. That is your night. The only one thing you can do in the night, weeping, weeping, weeping. Because you can't do anything. Sometime back you thought, nothing can shake you. Now you are reduced to the dust. They are mocking at you. They are teasing you. Only thing, they are biting your teeth. But you haven't given up hope. With repentance, with penitence, you are crying to the Lord. Lord, if I die in this situation, as a mockery to everybody, if I die, how could that be glory to you? Can my death declare the truth? Have mercy on me, Lord. One more time, Samson cried. One more time. In ஒரு விஷயம் எனக்கு இறங்கும் ஆண்டவரே. In ஒரு விஷயம் எனக்கு இறங்கும். எப்படி என்னை தூக்கி எடும்? But joy cometh with the morning. When the morning breaks, it breaks with the joy. The night there will be weeping. When you know that you can do nothing about it. The Spirit of the Lord is speaking to you. You never thought it would, this misfortune would come. When you are a king, you never thought that your son would throw you into the wilderness. You never thought that could happen. No enemy was able to stand against you. No Goliath was able to stand against you. Your own child, womb of the fruit of your womb, declared a coup over a night with a four-year plan. With a four-year plan. Declared a coup. Oh, David, Goliath is no match for you. God was with you. The Philistines were not a match for you. God was with you. Saul was not a match for you. God was with you. Today what happened? That Bacha, Absalom, where are you running away? He left some of his wife's concubines in the palace. A news comes. His own son slept with his wives. Bear with me for saying this. In your difficult situation, you hear a message. Your wife and your son are sleeping together. Will not break your heart? Should that happen in the house of a prophet? Should that happen in the house of a person who loved God the most? His wife and his son were sleeping together. If that could happen in the house of David, can anybody say that it will not happen in your house? Broken. But he says, in the morning, joy will come. The Lord would be able to bring back joy in your life. Very quickly, I tell you 9 points, only from this song, what the Lord can do in your life. Please make a note of these 9 points. In all these situations, he said one word, thou hast. You have done this, O Lord. For me to get joy back, for you to get joy back, your weeping will go away. Joy will come back. In verse 1, he says, I will extol thee, O Lord, for thou hast lifted me up. Thou hast lifted me up from the miry clay, from this difficult situation. Again I say, the Spirit of the Lord is speaking to you. You cannot come out. You cannot come out from your difficult situation. Only somebody has to lift you up. Nobody is there to lift you up. In the name of Jesus I tell you, it's a promise, Jesus will lift you up. If we can turn to him, he will turn to us. The first thing, how the joy would come with the morning, with the dawn, with the daybreak. How the joy would come when he lifts us up. Pray for that. Lord, lift me up. Number two, again in verse 1, I will extol thee, O Lord, for thou hast lifted me up and hast not made my foes to rejoice over me. Now your foes, they rejoice over you. They are shaking their heads against you. It appears that they got victory. Those who are expecting your fall, your neighbors, your relatives, Summa Sami Samir Pani, Yesi, Yesin Pani, Annachpatiya, they have to laugh at you. They have to shake your hands against, heads against you. It's apparent that the enemies have got victory. But when will the joy come with the morning when the Lord make my foes not to rejoice over me? A time will come. ஐயோ இப்படிலாம் நான் நினைச்சோமே, இப்படிலாம் நாங்கள் நினைச்சோமே. மை டியர் பிரதர், மை டியர் சிஸ்டர், ஃபார் த க்ளோரி ஆஃப் த லார்ட் ஐ டெல் யூ, இட்ஸ் ஆல் ஹியூமிலிட்டி. When certain situations came in our path of ministry, changes came. People who said, people who thought, even ridiculed. Robert is finished. His ministry is finished. With all humility, which I tell you, the Lord didn't allow those who thought of our fall to rejoice over us. It is His mercy. He lifted me up from my miry clay. And He didn't allow my foes to rejoice over you. When He didn't allow your foes to rejoice over you, joy will come with the morning. Joy will come with the morning. So first thing, joy will come with the morning when He lifts you up from your dire, difficult situation. Joy will come with morning, with the break of the day, when He will not allow your foes to rejoice over you. Number three, in verse 2, O Lord my God, I have cried unto thee, and thou hast healed me. Allow to draw your attention to the phrase, thou hast. You have healed me, O Lord. Sickness in the mind, just imagine. His own daughter was raped by his own son. His own son killed another son. Now his own son has declared a coup and chased him into the wilderness. He was sick mentally, he was 60 years old, running into the wilderness barefoot. He could not worship the Lord in the tabernacle. He desired to be at least in the courts of the tabernacle. Now he could not go to the tabernacle where the Ark of Covenant is kept. What all the efforts he took to bring that Ark to the city of David. Now he could not live in the palace he built for him, the house of David. He was sick mentally, spiritually, emotionally. His soul desired, probably desired death. He was like somebody who was getting into the pit. No hope. When the Lord healed him, joy comes with the morning. ஆண்டவர் உன்னை குணமாக்கும்போது விடியலோடு மகிழ்ச்சி வரும். அந்த காலை விடியும்போது மகிழ்ச்சியோடு விடியும். அந்த 4 வருஷமும் ஒரு இரவு, அந்த 4 ஆண்டுகளும் ஒரு இரவு. ஒரு காரியம் அவனால் செய்ய முடியல. இரவு என்றால் இயேசு சொன்னார், கிரியை செய்யக்கூடாத ராக்கள். ஹீ குட் டூ நத்திங் அண்ட் ஃபோர் இயர்ஸ் ஹீ குட் டூ நத்திங். வென் த டான் கம்ஸ், விடியல் வரும்போது, அதோடு மகிழ்ச்சி வரணும்னா தென் காட் ஹீல்ஸ் இஸ் சிக்னஸ். ஃபிசிக்கல் சிக்னஸ் வீக்னஸ் மோர் தென் தட் எமோஷனல் சிக்னஸ் குட் டூ நத்திங். ஹெட் இஸ் பெயினிங், நர்வ்ஸ் ஆர் புல்லிங், த ஃபீட் இஸ் ஏக்கிங், ஸோ மெனி திங்ஸ் ஆல் பிகாஸ் ஆஃப் யுவர் டென்ஷன், டிப்ரெஷன், சப்ரெஷன், அப்ரெஷன். When the Lord heals you, joy comes with the morning. We go to verse 3. Verse 3, again he says, O Lord, thou hast brought up my soul from the grave. Number 4, how the joy comes with the morning when the Lord brings up our soul. Our soul speaks about our sukhi, our psyche, our mindset. We will be studying this in our seminar. In our soul, we have got thinking, reasoning, will, emotion, everything in our soul. Now our soul is in the grave. His reasoning is in the grave. 60-year-old, now what he can do? He was, Ahithophel was helping him to plan, to give counsel. Now that counselor is on the other side. And the counsel of Ahithophel is like the counsel of God. So he is on the other side. Physically he is weak. He doesn't want to kill Absalom. He doesn't want to fight against Absalom. He could not fight against Absalom. He is not a match for Absalom now. Physically he is weak. So his soul was going into the pit. And the manam vittu poichinga. Manasula dhairiyam illa. Ini nammala mudiyum, nammala elumba mudiyum, nammala onnu seiya mudiyum appadina andha manasu nenikkalenga. Manasu vittu poichu. That the soul going into the grave. Soul going into the grave. The Lord has brought up my soul from the grave. Because the Lord has brought up my soul from the grave, joy comes with the morning. Joy comes with the morning. Number 5. Again verse 3. See, one after the other, one after the other. Number 5. Verse 3. O Lord, thou hast brought up my soul from the grave. Again see that phrase, thou hast. Thou hast kept me alive that I should not go down to the pit. The literal meaning is that I should not die. 61, 62, 63, painful years. But you are keeping me alive, Lord. That's why I am able to see the morning. அதனால தான் என்னால் விடியலை பார்க்க முடிகிறது. ஒரு வேளை அவன் செத்து போயிருந்தான்னா, சூசைட் பண்ணியிருந்தான்னா, என் பையனே அப்படி பண்ணிட்டான், இனி என்னால் வாழ முடியாது, ஆண்டவரும் கைவிட்டுட்டாரு, நான் என்னால் அந்த வில்டர்னஸில் கிடந்து கஷ்டப்பட முடியாது திரும்ப இந்த வயசான காலத்தில். என் ஃப்ரெண்டு, என்னுடைய ஆலோசகர், என் ஆத்மாத்ம நண்பர் அகிதோப்பியல், அவனே என் பையனோட சேர்ந்துட்டு எனக்கு விரோதமாக ஆலோசனை சொல்கிறான், நான் வாழ விரும்பலை. யூ குட் ஜஸ்ட் டேக் இஸ் சோட் அண்ட் பியர்ஸ் ஹின் செல்ஃப். கேன் யூ சீ த மார்னிங்? கேன் யூ சீ த காட்ஸ் மிரக்கர்? இஸ் ஈஸி டு டை, பட் தட் நாட் ஈஸி டு லிவ் ஃபார் ஹிம். சால் கமிட்டட் சூசைட் அண்ட் டைட். Saul committed suicide and died. He didn't want to live. He didn't want to see the future. He was defeated. He didn't want to have the defeat in the hands of Philistines. He preferred death. When he attempted suicide, he could not die. He told somebody, kill me. What we call today mercy killing. My dear brother, my dear sister. But why didn't we die in our misfortune? Family problems came, financial problems came, You didn't die because the Lord has kept you alive. You didn't die because the Lord has kept you alive. Not because you got the courage to face everything. You desired death. Death didn't come to you. Death didn't come to you. Praise God. Thou hast kept me alive that I should not go down to hell. It is God's mercy. How many times? In my weakness, I have thought, Lord, I don't want to live. I don't want to live. You don't want to live, you can do anything what you want to do when you don't want to live. There was a man praying. Then the angel of God came. உனக்கு என்னப்பா வேணும் என்ன ஜிப்ப வேண்டிக்கிட்டு இருக்க நான் சாகணும் அவ்வளோதானே அந்த புத்தில் கை வை பாம்பு இருக்கும் ஐயா பாம்பு கடிக்குமே நீ சாகணும்னு தானே விரும்புகிறேன் அந்த புத்தில் கை வை பாம்பு கடிக்கும் அவ்வளோதானே இதுக்கு போட்டு என் ப்ரே பண்ணுறேன் ஆண்டவரே என்ன எடுத்துக்கும் ஆண்டவரே என்ன எடுத்துக்கும் அதுக்கு எனக்கு ஜபிக்கணும் சாகணும்னா செத்து போயிடலாமே இதுக்கு போய் ஜபிக்கணுமா ஐயா என்னை காத்துறலும் எனக்கு கிருபத்தாரும் அதுக்காக ஜெபிச்சா மீனி கோபம் இயேசுவை என்ன எடுத்துக்கும்பா அதுக்கு தான் இயேசு இருக்காரா எவ்வளோ பைத்தியகாரத்தை பார்த்தீங்களா உடனே இயேசு என்ன எடுத்துக்கோ உங்களுக்கு சாக விருப்பம் இல்லை இந்த பிரச்சனையை சந்திக்க முடியலை சாகணும்னு நினச்சா என்னை காணலும் சாகலாமே பெரிய எதுக்கு ஆஸ்பத்திரிக்கு போகிறோம் பெரியதுக்கு மாத்திரை சாப்பிட்றோம் சாகணும்னு விரும்பியா பிரியமானுள்ள ஆஸ்பத்திரிக்கு போகிறது காரணமே வாழணும்னு விரும்புகிறதுனால தான் ஹார்ட்டை வெட்டினாலும் சரி இதை வெட்டினாலும் சரி ஆண்டவரே நான் வாழணும்னு விரும்பி தானே நம்ம சாகணும்னு விரும்புவது சாவை விரும்புவதனாலே அல்ல பிரச்சனையை சந்திக்க முடியாததினாலே பிரச்சனையை சமாளிக்க முடியாததினாலே விடியலை காண முடியாததினாலே விடியல் வரும் என்ற நம்பிக்கை இல்லாததினால ஆண்டவர் எனக்கு ஒரு அதிசயத்தை காண பண்ணுவார் என்று நம்ப முடியாததினாலே சாவ விரும்புகிறோம் சங்கீதக்காரன் சொல்கிறான் தவ் ஹஸ் கெப்ட் மீ அலைவ் தட் ஐ ஷுட் நாட் கோ டவுன் டு ஹெல் பிகாஸ் யூ ஹவ் கெப்ட் மீ அலைவ் ஜாய் கம்ஸ் வித் த மார்னிங் ஐ எம் ஏபிள் டு சீ த ஜாய் தட் த லார்ட் வாண்ட்ஸ் டு பிரிங் இன் மை லைஃப் எ விடியல் வில் கம் ஷியோர்லி எ விடியல் வில் கம் In the name of Jesus, I tell you, a vidyal will come. If you are alive, you can see that vidyal. If you are alive, you can see that daybreak. Before that, if you die, you can't see the daybreak. I'm talking spiritually. Number 6, let me go a little fast. Psalm 30 verse 7. Psalm 30 verse 7. Lord, by thy favor, thou hast made my mountain to stand strong. Lord, by thy favor, thou hast made my mountain to stand strong. Thou didst hide my face and I was troubled. I thought that I shall not be moved in verse 6. The Lord hid his face. I am troubled. Now I cried unto the Lord. I said, have mercy on me. The Lord is giving me a dawn. The Lord is permitting a daybreak in my life. Now I say, in your favor, my mountain will stand strong. In the name of Jesus, I tell you, in His favor, the Lord will make your business stand strong. In His favor, the Lord can make your ministry stand strong. The Lord, in His favor, can make your family stand strong. அவர் தயவு அவர் கிருபை உன் மேலே இருக்குமானா நீ அசைக்கப்படுவது இல்லை உன் குடும்பம் அசைக்கப்படாது உன் கணவன் மனைவி உறவு அசைக்கப்படாது Your husband-wife relationship will not be shaken. Your parents-children relationship will not be shaken. Your ministry will not be shaken. Your calling will not be shaken. Thou hast made my mountain stand strong. You have made my business stand strong. You have made my family stand strong. Before that, when that earthquake came, my family was shaken. We are to run away. In the name of Jesus, I tell you, by His favor, again that phrase, thou hast made my mountain stand strong. Number 7, we go to verse 30, verse 11. Thou hast turned for me, Thou hast turned for me my mourning into dancing. Last night, your mourning, your weeping, you are mixing your tears with your drink and drinking. When you are eating, your tear drops are falling on the food. தாவிது சொல்கிறான், என் போஜனத்தோடு கண்ணீரை கலந்து சாப்பிட்றேன். எப்படிங்க போஜனத்தோடு கண்ணீரை கலக்க முடியும்? பே வித் மீ ஃபார் சேயிங் திஸ் இன் தமிழ் ஸோ தட் யூ ஆல் கேன் அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட், ஸோ தட் ஐ கேன் எக்ஸ்பிரஸ் பெட்டர். வென் யூ ஆர் சிட்டிங் அண்ட் ஈட்டிங், அப்படியே சாப்பாடு இருக்கு, நல்ல சாம்பார்லாம் ஊற்றிருக்கிறீங்க, பிரச்சனை தாங்க முடியலை, சாப்பாட்டை எடுத்து வாயில் வைக்க குனிறீங்க, கண்ணீர் பிளேட்டில் சொட்டு சொட்டு சொட்டுன்னு விழுது, பிசைஞ்சு சாப்பிட்றீங்க. உன் ஆகாரத்தை கண்ணீரோடு கலந்து புசித்தாய். When the day breaks, when the Lord lifts you up, when the Lord will not make your foe to rejoice against you, when the Lord could heal you emotionally, mentally, physically, spiritually, when the Lord could keep you alive, the Lord can change your mourning into weeping. In the name of Jesus, I tell you, the night will pass by. The night will pass by. The day dawns. There your mourning will be turned into dancing. Same verse 11. Thou hast turned for me my mourning into dancing. Thou hast put off my sackcloth. Thou hast put off my sackcloth, my sorrow, my penitent prayer. No more joy. It is not only in my heart, it is seen outside. I don't like good food. I don't like merriment. I put ashes on me. Talks about your activities. The Lord can put off your sackcloth. And number 9, He will gird you again with gladness. So He was coming back to Jerusalem, to the palace. And I fully understand. He dedicated that place. And in verse 12 he says, to the end that my glory may sing praise to thee. My glory, my character. I as a king, I will not be arrogant anymore. To the end of my life, I never would say that I couldn't manage. I could do this. It is because of my strength. It is because of my effort. No, Lord, to the end of my life, my glory, my character, my success, my glory may sing praise to Thee, O Lord, and not be silent. I'm not going to be silent. I'm going to tell everybody what the Lord has done, how the Lord has brought me back from this exile to the palace again. I never thought that I would come back to this palace. I thought that I will die in the wilderness. I was sick. I was broken. I was downcast. Lord, I will not be silent anymore. If I have been to that pit, if I went down pit, I cannot declare your truth. Now you have brought back me to the palace. Joy has come with the morning, O Lord. I will not be silent. O Lord, my God, I will give thanks unto thee forever and ever. As long as I live, I give thanks unto thee. With that he starts the whole psalm in verse 1. I will extol thee, O Lord. I will extol thee, O Lord, because the Lord has lifted me up. Andavare, na umai uyarthuven, umai pottuven, umai pugaluven, neer enna uyarthirukkire. Thoolilirundhu thooki eduthirukkire, ayya. Saavilirundhu thooki eduthirukkire. நாவுமை புகழாமல் இருப்பது எப்படி, நாவுமை போற்றாமல் இருப்பது எப்படி? ஐ வில் எக்ஸ்டால் தி ஓ லார்ட். இன் வர்ஸ் ஃபோர் ஹி சேஸ், சிங் அன் டு த லார்ட் ஓ ஹி செயின்ஸ் ஆஃப் ஹிஸ். ஹி டெல்ஸ் அதர்ஸ், ஹி டெல்ஸ் அதர்ஸ், திஸ் வாட் காட் ஹஸ் டன் ஃபார் மீ. ஓ செயின்ஸ் ஆஃப் ஹிஸ், சிங் அன் டு தி அண்ட் கிவ் தேங்க்ஸ் அட் த ரிமெம்பரன்ஸ் ஆஃப் ஹிஸ் ஹோலினஸ். கிவ் தேங்க்ஸ் டு த ரிமெம்பரன்ஸ் ஆஃப் ஹிஸ் ஹோலினஸ். As there are few more hours for him, probably he was now at 74. The last words of David in 2 Psalm 23 verse 1, the Bible says, David, the son of Jesse, the sweet psalmist of Israel. Israel. இனிமையான சங்கீதக்காரே. உரிஷ நதீன மாற, வென் யூ டை ஹெவன்ஸ் வில் டிக்ளேர், இட் இஸ் ரிட்டர்ன் இன் த ஸ்கிரிப்சர்ஸ், எ மேன் ஹூ சின்ட், எ மேன் ஹூ ஹாஸ் புரோக்கன், எ மேன் ஹூ ஹாஸ் காஸ்ட் அவுட், இஸ் நாட், he didn't die as a word of curse. In 2 Samuel 23, 1, the Bible declares, David, son of Jesse, the sweet Urishalamarama. Yesterday when I was preparing, I was moved to tears. Lord, the sweet servant of God, Robert, the sweet preacher, Urishadamadabadira. Is not what the world says. It is recorded in the Bible. A simple shepherd boy went through different facets of his life, became a king. For 17 years he was a king. Pride set in. Sin came in. The Lord hid his face. He was troubled in every way. Thrown out of the kingdom. He was sick. His soul was going into the pit. Walking in the night. Could do nothing. The Lord lifted him up. Healed him. He didn't allow his enemies to brag against him. Turned his mourning into dancing. The night passed away. Joy came in the morning. In the name of Jesus, I tell you, there is a daybreak for you. With love and affection, with tears, I give the word of God to you. There is a daybreak for you. The Lord will not leave you, brother. The Lord will not leave you, sister. A new year has come. All things passed away. His mercy endureth forever. Urishna Madhira Bharava Shankaraba. Sayangalatra Alugai Thanga. Vidimbudha Kalipundaga. Urishna Madhira Bharava Shankaraba. Urishna Madhira Bharava Shankaraba. The Spirit of the Lord has spoken to you. I love to pray with you. Shall we all stand to our feet? I love that you could have your eyes closed. You need not see who is to your left or to right. If you know the Lord has spoken to you, put your hand on your chest, look unto him. The Lord will turn away your sorrow into mourning, into rejoicing. You shall weep no more. Your days of battles are over. the sorrow will be turned into rejoicing. Undukkam sandoshamai maru. Urisha nakadi namarava shankarava. Urisha namalabalabadi namarava. God has got mercy on you. God cannot rejoice over your fall. God cannot rejoice over your misfortune. Lord may to hide his face, but just for a moment. With all his mercies, he is looking unto you. Urishanam, confess your weaknesses unto him. With that daybreak, joy will come. Dear Father God, I love to pray with you. Those who love to join me, hallelujah, put your hand on your chest. Urishanam, Katharangalodi pesi irukra, nanungalikaga jabike vendamenta. என்னோடு ஜபத்தில் இணையும்படியா உங்களுடைய வலது கருத்தை உங்களை நெஞ்சிலே வைத்துக் கொள்ளுங்க. நான் உங்களுக்காக ஜெபிக்கிறேன். நன்றி ஆண்டவரே, நன்றி ஆண்டவரே. சோனி தீனமாறவா, ஷனமாறவா, உரீனமாறவா. ஒரே ஒரு பல்லவி, ஜஸ்ட் ஒன் கோரஸ். தொல்லை கஷ்டங்கள் சூழ்ந்திடும், இன்பம் துன்பமாய் மாறும். தட் ஹேப்பன் இன் த life of David. அவனுடைய இன்பம் துன்பமாய் மாறிச்சு. ஆனாலும் கத்தடத்திலிருந்து தயை வரும். உரிஷனமாரபா. We sing that chorus and I'll pray with you. தொல்லை கஷ்டங்கள் சூழ்ந்திடும்,
தொல்லை கஷ்டங்கள் சூழ்ந்திடும்,
துக்கம் வரும். நேரிடும்ாய் தோன்றும் எங்கும் சொல்லமை சொல் கேட்கும் செவிரிலேருந்து ஜெயம் வரும். பரமுன்னை காக்க வல்லோரிலிருந்து ஜெயம் வரும். பரமுன்னை காக்க வல்ல வலது கரத்தை உயர்த்தி கக்கும் வந்த தேவன் உண்டனுக்கு உண்டனுக்கு நாமே நாமே காக்கும் வல்ல தேவன் உண்டனுக்கு காத்திடுவா
ஐயம்
இருந்ததோ
இருந்ததோ
ஆவியின் குறைவால்
தான்.
ஆமே என் பயம் யாரும் நீங்கிற்று. He lifted me up, O Lord. Em baya ella ningitaya. Glory. Amen ya, amen ya. Amen. வல்ல மீட்ப உண்டனுக்கு 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 காக்கும் வல்ல மீட்ப உண்டனுக்கு காத்திடுவான் என்று நீ காத்திடுவான் என்று நீ. Fear no evil. பொல்லாப்புக்கு பயப்படாதே. உரிஷனம் உன் துக்கம் சந்தோஷமாய் மாறும். Your mourning will be turned into rejoicing, into dancing. ஊரீஷனமாதீரவா சாயங்காலத்தில் அழுகை தங்கும், விடியற் காலத்திலோ மகிழ்ச்சி உண்டாகும். ஊரீஷனமாரவா விதம் ஹலில் ஜாய் கம்ஸ் விதமானே. தெர் இஸ் அ டான் ஃபார் யூ, தெர் இஸ் அ டே பிரேக் ஃபார் யூ. திஸ் நைட் வில் நாட் கண்டினியூ. ஊரீஷனமாதீர் ஐ ஆம் வித் யூ சேஸ் த லார்ட். ஹலில் ஊரா நமாரபா, ஹலில் ஊரீ நமாரபா, ஊரீஷனமாதீரவா. த லார்ட் வில் மேக் your mountain stand strong. The Lord will make your life stand strong. The Lord will make your family stand strong. Urishanadi namaraba. Dear Father God, bless your people. Bless them with all your blessings. Urishanamadi raba. Help us extol thee. Let our glory ever praise thee, O Lord. Never glory to praise ourselves. Let our glory praise thee always. We will not be silent, O Lord. We declare your truth to all nations. You will be a sweet person in the sight of God. It will be written in the scriptures, David, son of Jesse, a sweet psalmist. Your children will say, a sweet mother, a sweet father. The parish will say, a sweet pastor, a sweet pastor ma. Your friends will say, a sweet friend. In the name of Jesus, amen. Amen. Amen.